Alright, what's up guys? This is going to be a little bit different of a video, because it is my 1,000 subscribers kind of woo video, and I'm showing off the new NAS that I'm using to edit, which is a free NAS build. This, my R630 that has 4 RAID 0'd SSDs, and it's super fast and super powerful, and honestly, overkill, but awesome. All right, and so first off, I just want to say thank you to everybody who subscribed, and honestly, like, it's kind of helped me build this kind of community thing. It's really cool that people are getting a lot out of my videos. I really enjoy making them, and so it's always nice. The next thing, I figured I'd go over the R630 that I bought about, I want to say about 3 or 4 weeks ago, and I've been using it ever since as an editing server. So I edit using Final Cut Pro, which has some awesome features like auto-generating optimized media and things like that. But project files can easily reach a terabyte in size. And so I was really trying to figure out what the best way to get a terabyte of working files is, especially when I would have 2 or 3 projects going at once. And so I settled on an R630 with 4 SSDs in there in a basically RAID 0 configuration. Since it's FreeNAS, it's actually ZFS, which isn't really RAID 0, it's a strange JBOB that is strewn across 4 different disks. And so I can get some just incredible performance out of this. The R630 I got has 2 10 gigabit SFP plus ports on there, and I've got them link aggregated. So that means I can get 2 different 10 gigabit streams out of it, and so I will not be saturating that anytime soon. Although FreeNAS tries pretty hard, especially when stuff's already in the RAM, which I've got 128 gigs of RAM in there. And so a lot of the files I'm working with are able to be in there. And so I can easily get 800 megabytes read and write out of the server from one machine while not even affecting the ability for the other machine. And so the goal for this is to be able to have multiple editors working on this thing without causing any issues, as well as doing routine snapshots. And it's got 16 cores with 32 logical processes in there. So it's also going to be used for a bunch of high-performance automation tasks, like video encoding, hopefully. But I'm working with Jails right now to kind of figure that all out. So the reason I chose the R630 over any of the other servers, it really was the perfect intersection between price, power usage, and fan usage, and performance. So I really wanted to have 2 10 gigabit connections on there, so I would not be hitting any bottlenecks, so I could do as much as I wanted to there. And an all-in-one package makes it a lot cheaper. These servers were cutting edge about 5 years ago, but now are pretty much getting pulled out of a lot of places that turn over their servers quickly, and so you can get them super cheap off eBay. The other thing is, this generation of Dell servers is one of the ones that had the biggest power savings, and so they're not like the older machines that just suck down power. And because of that, it's actually really quiet. It is almost silent whenever it's in the room with you. It's one of those things where you actually have to listen for it to hear it. I'm not gonna try to do a decibel test or anything like that because, well, you can look those up online and really, I think they're arbitrary. But I'd say that it's really quiet when it's idling or even when I'm editing from it. Although when it boots up, it sounds like a jet engine taking off. So you gotta be ready for that. So the drives I've got in there are 2 Samsung 500 gig SSDs that I've had. I actually pulled them out of my DS1819 Plus. Those are the ones that I was using for the SSD cache. And I just stuck them in there. And it consists of 1 mirrored VDEV, which is the equivalent of a RAID 1 configuration. And the reason I did that is I wanted a drive that was completely stable and had a RAID configuration. So if one of them died, I would not lose things on that drive. And that's where I'm going to be running virtual machines from and things like that. And then on my working folder, I am fine losing the entire data on there because it's actually already contained on my DS1819 Plus. It's just I would have to rebuild the project, which does not take long. Final Cut actually does automatic backups of the settings. It doesn't back up the media files, but all of my media files, as soon as they come off my card, are actually transferred into the DS1819 Plus before they go anywhere. And so that means I could restore any of these projects from even a year ago. And so I don't feel the need to have redundancy there. And that means I can get some huge disks with some huge performance out of them. And then I do have one like general resources Final Cut Pro project that's going to live on there long term, which has a nightly rsync to my DS1819+, meaning that if there is a drive failure, I'll be able to restore that one without any trouble at all. I originally was planning on actually using a RAID card with it, so I actually purchased the H730, but really found that that is not necessary. In doing a speed test comparison, I found that FreeNAS with the H330 flashed to IT mode, which basically passes the disks through, because FreeNAS needs the disks directly through, I actually was getting better performance in Final Cut than I was when I was working it with a RAID card and I was using Ubuntu Samba server. And so I've kind of finally gotten everything worked out pretty well, so I'm going to start doing some videos on that. And let me know any other things you're interested in. All right, well, I think that's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and thanks for subscribing. Have a good one. Bye.